Going camping again. Missing a member this time. We've got Esky instead of Mummy. So yeah, it's just me, Jayden in the back. Hell of a lot less gear and nothing on the roof. And just going out for one night, going back to Broadwater for a father-son camping trip. And hopefully I'll have a bit better audio this time. I think I've worked out what the problem was. And we'll see how we go, show you a bit more of Broadwater when we get there. Not going to show you any of the way up, really, because I showed that in the last video, so everyone should you know, figure that one out by themselves now. And, yeah, we'll see you again when I get there. All right. Well, we're here. Looks like we're going to have a few neighbours. The bus that was here last time. And some other people that we're going to go past, and we'll see where we're going to set up. All right, well, I found which one I'm going to camp at. And, yeah, so we're going to set up. First things first. Hey, buddy, first things first, we got to get a drink. Okay, so we're going to open the esky here and grab yourself a rum.
Set up the tent.
But drinks first. All right, so we got our little tent set up. Hey, we bought this one special just for me and Jayden trips. Or over, just overnighters like this one. Here we've got the car there. Fire, pit ring, whatever. Some logs just bought because I didn't feel like doing special trips on the for axing. Just for one night, a couple of chairs. Spoke to a guy over there, he said it didn't rain or anything last night. The forecast isn't for rain, so we're not going to bother setting up a tarp or anything like that. Sky's pretty clear.
Go.
Yes. What's that, Jayden?
Go.
Yes, that's the car. Hey. So yeah, we're just gonna go nice and fairly simple tonight. Just brought a small esky, small container of food, just me and him. So we didn't really need to bring much, which is good. And yeah, we're pretty much set up. Took us not even half an hour. So yeah, we're doing well. Gonna go have a bit of an explore, maybe find a little bit of kindling just to start the fire off. And see how we go, should be a good night. All right, we're going down to the beach or the shallow end of the creek. So we go down here. Hey, yeah, hold my hand. Big step. Yeah, down across this bridge. Now it has been known to actually get water in the flooding wet season right up across this bridge. As you can see, there is a bit of a creek bed that comes through here. And yeah, every now and then it does flood. There's some debris up in the tree. Shows just how high the water can get in the wet season. So yeah, we're going down and we'll take some video down by the what we call the beach. It's a little bit less worn than it used to be, even though there seems to be a more popular campsite now. But anyway, obviously people are just jumping in from at the deep end up there. But we like coming down here because we've got little one. And yeah, there's a bit of a beach area where it's nice and shallow and steady and not too deep for him. So we'll go down and show you that. All right, we're just about here now. It's only a couple of, maybe 20 metres. If you look closely, you'll see the bridge through there. We've just come along the path, turned off. This is the beach area. Someone's made a little wall to make some calm water. A little bit deeper for the parents who have to sit here with the kids. And you can see some rapids over there. You're right, come down, buddy. We've got the little man doing his four-wheel drive thing. Hey. The water's not particularly high this time, but obviously there's enough here. You're right. Oh, no, I'm not picking you up. Okay, and this is what we call the beach. This is little area here. As I said, nice and shallow for younger kids who just splash around as opposed to actually swimming. Some rapids up there that you can come down on tubes or kayaks and things like that. Come down through the rapids, And down there you can see some kids playing in the deep end, in the pontoon, which I'll show you later. There's some people on it at the moment, so I'll go back down there a bit later when nobody's there and show you what it's like from that end. It is actually quite deep down there, you know, about a meter and a half or so. Shallows off over to the inside of the corner. And yeah, it can sometimes get a lot of water flow, sometimes only a little bit like this, and we have seen it at times where there's been just about none. No, we don't throw sticks in the creek, buddy. Hey, someone, whoever's built this wall, actually knows what they're doing, because they've made a little outlet on this side, which allows the water flow and stops it going with lots of mouldy and algae and all of that kind of thing, because there's still just that little bit of movement. So, yeah, this is the shallow end of the creek and the rapids and the beach. Okay, I'm going to go up and show you sort of the top pond at the height of the rapids. There's the beach there. Rapids through there. See, we've got the little big man. Actually, we're going to go up this way, buddy. There's a back track and a front track, I guess. One that sort of sticks right by the river. It doesn't really get you anywhere because there's only rapids there. And then there's this track, a little bit less worn again, as I say. Not many people bother coming up to this top pool when there's the one with the pontoon down the bottom. But yeah, so we're going to go up to the top and have a bit of a look in the top pool. And yeah, here we are, top pond. As I said, it's a lot less shallow. It does get deeper up that end, but yeah, not a bad little place to sit and chill if you bring the esky up. And set a little bit more secluded than down there if there's other people in the park. And yeah, nice little creek in general. Alright, well, I've just finished chopping up some more firewood. The bags actually give you pretty big bloody pieces, so I've axed it up. This is what we've got. This was two bags, $24 worth. So starting with the little, working up to the big logs. I don't know how many of those I'll use. We're only here for one night, but we've got them there anyway. We'll be cooking on it in the morning. Make some toast. So I'll probably get a little bit more kindling from around the place just to get it going, because it's all hardwood here. I don't know whether you can tell if anybody knows, but that's all hardwood. It'll take a while to get going. So yeah, I'm going to find some softer, smaller stuff that'll light a bit easier until we can get some heat into that. And we'll have a good fire going, hopefully, tonight. So we've been sitting here, and he's just ran out. But that turkey over in the back there, that one over there, was actually just in the fire pit eating the leftovers from lunch. We threw Jayden's sandwiches in there and his crusts. And yeah, and the turkey was just in there. We thought we might have some easy dinner. But apparently it's not meant to be, because he just ran away when I came over to film him. Oh well, guess it's back to the soup idea. Well, we're getting all kinds of nature here today. I'm going to wipe this lens again. Yeah, look, we got a goanna over here by the pole there. Quite a big one too. Can you see him, Jayden? Hey, can you see him? Okay. Mm-hmm. It's all right. You stand here and watch him.
That.
Hey, yeah, you watch him. It's been a while since I've seen a goanna here, actually. We used to see them quite regularly. They've been gone for a little while. Maybe we used to make too much noise when I was young and drunk and playing music all the time. He seems to have skirted around our camp a bit, though, which is good. I'm going to follow him just a little, make sure he doesn't sort of come back towards the tent. But I think we'll just leave him go on his way. He's actually quite big. So, yeah. It's quite nice to see some wildlife back in here. Alright, well, we're going to try and start our fire now. I'm going for a bit of an old school method. No lighter. Just using the flint and the bushman's knife here, trying to get some skills happening. It's been many, many years and we've always used lighter and stuff like that, so I want to see if I can do it. Get this going just without anything, without any help. Just old school method. And we'll see how we go. You hold that. Okay, hold it there. Show it on the fire. Down, not too close. There we go. Okay, took a bit, but we got some flame going, which is good. Throw a couple of sticks on that dryer lint. See if we can't get this thing cooking, hey? Hey, hands out, buddy, hot. So there we go. As I said, took a little bit, but we got some fire going there. Hands out, buddy. Hot. We'll see how we go. We'll keep this thing going. Have a good fire tonight. Well, I've had to keep working at it and keep putting some effort and some thought into it. But so far we've got it going. We're still burning. We haven't had to use any other extra ignitables. Hey, Jayden's got the pot over there. We're going to have some soup for dinner, just a can of soup going to go in that pot. Hey, we're not going to cook that tea towel up. Hey, we do actually have some food, proper food for dinner. So yeah, so far I think I've done alright for my first attempt at a non-ignitable fire, or whatever you want to call it. You know, using only nothing flammable except for the timber. You know, no. I don't even know what the word is, but no flammable liquids or fire lighters or anything like that. Just a simple dry lint, and you know, the sparks off the flint. So I think that's not a bad effort. First time I've ever tried it, so that's good. Getting some hardwood burning now, which should keep some heat in there, give us some coals and cook some dinner up, which would be nice, and keep us warm until we decide to go to bed. So yeah, we visited some neighbours earlier. We visited this mob just when the first lot was there, just that Pajero, two lovely young ladies. And over in the distance there, there's another older couple. We went and said hello to them and had a bit of a chat. Oh, yep, we'll video that. What's that, Jayden?
Lid.
Fire, yeah. Hot. Hot fire.
Cup.
That's not a cup. That's a billy. Billy can. Alright. I'm going to have to throw a little bit more on this fire now so we can keep it going so it doesn't die down too much. And we'll get our soup on for dinner fairly shortly. There should be some nice heat in there to cook our soup up and get it hot. Cook our damper. So I've just finished making a bit of a damper, bread, whatever you want to call it. Nice big roll there of dough. Just letting it rest for a little bit. I'm going to go and find some sticks and we'll throw this over the fire. Just clean off the spoon. Continuing the theme of last camping trip with trying to cook on the fire more as opposed to using the gas stove. We just got our soup to go over there tonight. Just doing up some damper to go with it. And should be interesting. Yeah, we'll go find some sticks to cook this damper on. And the fire there is still going. Still going strong. That hardwood's starting to burn now, which is good. Getting some heat in there. We should make us some nice coals to cook over. And yeah, keep the heat there for later on. Cheers. Anyway, we've got our pumpkin and sweet potato soup. Got our bread down in the bowl there, damper, whatever you want to call it. How's it taste, buddy? Yeah, you got some bread. There's our fire going. We've gone through the wood a bit quicker than I would have liked, but anyway, we'll be right. And we'll sit here by the fire, maybe go and visit some friends, maybe over there somewhere. Go and visit somebody else later on, maybe. Yes, Jayden's eating the bread. Down in the mouth. Yummy, yummy dinner. Alright, we'll leave it at that for now. Cheers. Well, we had dinner. Had to give him a bit of a little bit of just normal bread because he didn't like his soup and damper. He's always been a little bit fussy with his eating, but you know, that's what you get with a 2.5-year-old. Gone a little bit weird at the moment. I'm not used to being by myself, to be honest. We went in Jayden's mouth there. It's sort of a little bit strange and I'm a little bit in a weird place, I guess, with my brain. As I said, not used to being by myself and that sort of thing. Stop, please, Jayden. No, we don't need to go in your mouth again. Still, we've got a bit of a fire going on, and you know, that's nice, I guess. No, that's not for drinking, buddy. That's going to be for your shower. You're going to have a shower soon, and we'll put you in your jammies. How about we go over that way for a minute, and Daddy will send this message. So anyway, it's still a decent trip. I'm just, a bit weird. One of them things that you kind of got to deal with, I guess. I don't know, whatever. Don't know how much you can see, but there's me and Jayden here. We're just chilling by the fire. I haven't added much more on there. Just letting it burn all that hardwood down now. And time is so at 6:35. As you can see, starting to get a bit dark out here. Not like the city where it stays light till 7 o'clock because of all the artificials. But, yeah, no, it's not too bad. By the fire, it's still nice and warm. We've given Jayden a bath. Anyway, shower, hey? Had a shower on the side of the car with the warm water. Now he's in his pajamas, in his onesie. And, yeah, just sitting here chilling. Oh. All right, so we're next morning, just before 7 o'clock. Come out from the tent and a little bit chilly. Not as cold as last time we were here, though. And we've had a look in the fire pit. That's what's left. There's still a little bit of heat there, so I'll get that going a bit later on. But for now, we've got the bread. We got the Jayden. We're going to go down the creek, see if we can find some fish and give them a bit of a feed. So yeah, it should be fun. Alright, so this is the pontoon, or what we call the deep end. And it's a little bit over chest deep here. There's the rapids up there where we were yesterday. And then that goes down to the other end by where we did the walk last time we were here. That goes past the creek out that way. So we got some bread, we got a Jayden, and we're going to feed some fish. Can you see all the fish? Ready? Look at the turtle. Can you see him? Turtle! There's actually quite a few big fish in here too. Like you can see down there, what I should have done was bought the waterproof case. But it's still up there in the car, so I'll probably just leave it there. Big eel down under the bottom there. Hey, let's see if he gets that bread. Hey, oh, there he goes. Oh God, I hope that came up on the camera.
Look.
Yeah, it's a big eel. All right, Jayden, so what did we see in the creek? Hey, what's in the creek? Did we see fish?
Fish.
Hey? Yeah? Did we see fish? And did we see turtle?
Fish.
And did we see an eel? Yeah, in the creek down there, hey, we saw fish, and a turtles, and an eel. We got a bit of wildlife everywhere today. Just come in to get some of that kindling. We got little birds in the trees. Just fluttering around. In through the middle there. Well, we took a little bit again. I'm obviously still learning this skill. But I got there, we got some fire going now, and this kid's happy, aren't you, buddy?
Fire.
Hey, say fire, hot.
Oh.
Yeah, it's on, isn't it? Not too close.
Daddy.
Yeah. Daddy's got the fire going.
Ouch.
Okay. I'm just going for a bit of a walk. Kill a bit of time, let the tent dry off before we pack it down. So Jayden's going to do some firming for you. There you go, buddy. All right, we got Jayden in the car. Campsite's clear, fire's put out, and everything's packed away. Time to hit the road, go home and see Mummy, hey? Go home and see Mum.
Well, it looks like somebody's all tuckered out. Camping does that to him. Haven't even got back to Hingham yet. We're about maybe 5k's off of the dirt, and he's already asleep. So yeah, hopefully he'll sleep the whole way home. It'd be a nice quiet trip back. It'd be good. It's been a pretty good camping trip for this time. First time I've ever brought him out by myself. Apart from, you know, one little bit there, I think I did okay. He's still alive and breathing and happy, so it's good. Got a lovely cane train going across up there. Just slowing down for that. This is just as we're passing back through Trebon.
As you can see, it is actually quite a long train, so you definitely don't want to pull in front of one of those, because it's just not going to stop for you. There's a little helper engine on the back.
Home again, home again.
How you doing, big man? Going and see Mum? Hey, going and give Mummy a cuddle? Papa!
Hey, another fun camping trip. Done and dusted, over. Can't wait till next time.